everybody. Thanks for going lunch and listening to me. So we are actually two people presenting. It's me and my imaginary friend David Cardon that nobody actually ever saw in a conference but me. And it's actually him who prepared the slides just 5 minutes ago. So thank you, Michael, for taking some time so that we could finalize it. So the agenda, it will be introduction to import filters. Then we will speak a little bit about filter configuration in LibreOffice. Then we will speak about the use of XSRT filter that Michael makes like so much. And then we will give example of integration of LibreVench-based filter and also an example of an easy way of setting a new LibreVench-based library. Since I have 15 minutes, I will be speaking without breathing. So, introduction to import filters. Why to write import filters? So, yeah, that's a good question actually, because as we know, ODF is the future of the humanity. The only problem is that humanity doesn't know it yet. So, so there are other file formats that are not ODF, and there are also users that want to be able to read them. So it is not our fault that we have to write import filter, it is the humanity and the users. So, and we decided that we will be nice and we will be play along with the humanity and the users. So even if they don't play the same according to the same rules. So what are the options in LibreOffice for writing import filters? They are the easiest filters in the world that are called XSRT filters. Then I will explain something about them, and I see a nice smile on Svante's face because he used to be the one who was taking care of this thing. So Svante, if I say something very stupid, please keep it up. Or one can do a full-blown filters that are different from XSRT filters. And one can use one of the existing framework. We have actually two new frameworks in LibreOffice. One is called LibreVench framework because it's based on the LibreVench APIs. And another one is Orcas framework that is based on LibOrcas that Kohi and Marcos, who are happily not here, he is here, know something about. Or we can produce ODF or better flat ODF as an intermediate format for internal filter frameworks in LibreOffice. Or we can use the UNO to directly create the document from, create the UNO structure of the document directly from the file. Or we can do another thing, we can push the document into internal LibreOffice structure. There are filters, they do this. Or we can use, no, we can't use because it's deprecated, but there used to be an XMerge framework that is basically Java framework. Oh, XSRT filters, it's easy. But it works only for pure XML formats. It's quite hard to write an XSRT filter for something like binary Visio file. There is also this character of XSRT that is setting itself in the write-only mode that makes it a bit difficult to write something else than just easy filter by XSRT, because even the author himself 2 weeks after will not remember what actually he was wanting to achieve and what the sheet means. Sheet, S-H-E-E-T, I mean. And also in LibreOffice, only XSRT 1.0 is supported out of the box because we use libxsrt for XSRT transforms, which is good because libxsrt is extremely quick. It's better than a Java-based framework, but it doesn't have some nifty 2.0 features that many of XSRT writers love. As to use of existing framework, LibreVench, I actually pretty like this framework. I don't know why, but It's a document liberation project framework. It's called LibRevenge Library because document liberation project is a project of a revenge. I mean reverse engineering. And we support text, presentation, vector graphics, and spreadsheets for the wild. We use ODF as an intermediate format. We have a library that actually takes the APIs of LibRevenge and uses them to generate ODF. So, and there are already dozens of existing import libraries supporting many formats like WordPerfect, Publisher, Visio, Works, CorelDRAW, Adobe PageMaker, and Keynote, and whatever. Very many things. Orcas, that's Kohei's and Marcus's. Marcus, David wrote you et al, but that's basically you. It supports spreadsheets. Again, internally supports ODF, OpenXML, numeric, CSV. For the while, no other filters use it for, but it can be reused. Why to use one of these frameworks? Because it's much easier than UNO. And also UNO is somehow a world that of its own, and sometimes when you are just a programmer and not UNO expert, you might get confused by already by UNO syntax and UNO operators and okay, we can have some unsupported features still in these frameworks, but it's software, so we can always support unsupported features, or we accept patches very happily. And in our opinion, the best choice is this for the less important file formats. Why I say less important file formats? If the file format needs to be quick writing and reading, it might be not the best solution to go through several intermediary APIs. The production of ODF as an intermediary format, it's slower, but we don't need to. This is another filter type. Produce just ODF XML. Slower, but there is no need for any framework or even UNO, because there are already filter adapters that interface with UNO. And we have two existing filters that that use this approach. But given our bias, we still think that it's probably easier to use LibRevenge instead. So we can use directly UNO. There are existing filters that do it, like the OXML filters that use UNO, RTF filter, and many of those that I don't remember because the German guy called Alzheimer is hiding them from me. And also filter can be extension, because extensions can use UNO, like for example Quellen's OpenOffice.org DIA filter. OpenOffice.org DIA filter has quite funny prefix. I don't know what it means, but the DIA filter part, it means that it's importing DIA diagrams. So, and for use of internal LibreOffice structures, it's the fastest. It has the high potential of breaking things, because you are touching things that only Quellen and Stefan Bergman understand. And there are legacy filters like Vault 1 or Vault 8. It means the Microsoft Vault binary filters. And we just hope that nobody is considering doing that for a new filter. That's it for this part. And concerning the XMatch framework, it was Java only. We removed all existing filters in 4.0. It's possible that there are still external filters using this framework. But if you want to write a filter, forget that XMatch existed. So very quickly about XSLT filters. Creating a new XSLT filter is extremely easy. Tools, XML filter settings, all you need is to have an XSL transform that converts a foreign XML-based file format to flat ODF. Yeah, that's if you know how to write the transform, you can integrate it very easily. We have certain number of XSLT-based filters in LibreOffice, they even work, I think. When you are setting up a new filter, you have to choose filter name. The general tab, you have to choose filter name, file type, and file extension. File type is basically what will be receiving the document. If you convert spreadsheets, you will want to know what will be the XML that you will be putting out. LibreOffice Writer XSV, it means that it uses OpenOffice Org 1.0 file format in flat version, and it will be a writer document. File extension, that is pretty easy because it's basically the extension that the files that you are going to convert will be using. And the application that will receive the converted document, it's the writer. Because we have to specify so that it doesn't try to load it into Calc, for example. So you can see how easy it is. And then you can, in the transformation tab, you put doc type, if applicable, XSLT for import, template for import if needed. Template, it means that if the file format you are importing is a file format that doesn't have style with itself, like for example, docbook file format you need some style for the document to have when you import it into LibreOffice. If the file format you are importing is just a meta, just the data, and you want to make a nice something nice visual, so it is possible to request use of XSLT 2.0 processor, but requires installing XSLT2 transformer extension. So you can see how the dialog looks, and that's it. There is a possibility to export this as an extension, and that's it. It's very easy, given that you know the XSLT and you know how to write it, so that it actually does something meaningful that I doubt anybody but Svante knows. So now LibreOffice needs some things to be done so that it considers the filter as a filter. We have to make a filter configuration, and the configuration, there are XML fragments that are describing the filter itself and the type the filter is handling. Type describes the file format, filter specifies how to handle the type. It means which service will import it, and similar thing. It is possible to have more filters for the same type importing to different document services. We have HTML that we can import as web document or as writer document. So. These fragments are then assembled by a custom tool into a big XML file in the LibreOffice installation. And the type property, what you put there, there are extensions, there is MIME type, there is detect service, the service that is able to detect whether this document actually is of this type. There are some about preferred, whether this type is primary for the extension, and preferred filters and UI name of the type, so it appears in the dialogue with the right name, and that one is localizable, and you can put some different patterns. Let me just show you an example. For example, for the publisher for Microsoft published a document. The detect service is called CompSunStar CompDrum MS Pub Import Filter. So the importer implements the detection function. Also, the extension is pub. MIME type is application. X MS Publisher preferred. Yes, for this file format is the only filter we have, so it's preferred. And then it's publisher document that is filtered that will handle it. So, and in the UI in English, it will appear as Microsoft Publisher. For filter properties, there is a filter service, then document service which will receive it. Like for example, CompSunStar drawing document. Let me actually give you the example, because it will be in the slides and it's not necessary really to go completely through it. For example, we have the name of the filter for that is publisher document. There are all the options. It's import filter only, it's alien, it's not internal filter. There are uses option, third party filter preferred. I explained everything there, but it's not something that you would want to, you want to know it only when you need it. So for filter service, this one is going to be imported into Draw, and the name in the UI, it will be Microsoft Publisher 97 to 2010. The file format version is 0. I don't know whether it changes anything. And it links to the type. As the type links to the filter, the filter links to the type, so that they are cross-linked with each other. And that's we have. Yeah, no, this filter service is what is the service name of the filter? So when we get this, when the type is detected and calls the filter, so then you know which service will actually convert the document. So for adding a new filter, you have to create this config for the format in filter source config fragments types. The easiest way is to copy something that already exists and modify it. Add a file to an appropriate filter configuration, add type section in filter configuration filter and make file so that it's not just there and nobody is using it. Create also the filter configuration and then add it to the make file, and it will get merged like that. Now, the most intelligent way still writing filters for LibreOffice is to use the LibreVenge framework. That is state-of-art best framework of the world. The source code location, the code that integrates all these LibreVenge-based libraries is a write-a-perfect module. In the write-a-perfect source core is the generic part, and then you have per application filter specific for application, so that LibreVenge framework-based filters, we don't produce a zillion of shared libraries. We have one shared library per application, so that packages, they can add it to Calc, add it to Writer, and so we have Calc, Writer, Draw directories for that. If you create a new library based on LibreVenge API, it requires adding new header and source file to appropriate application directory. Again, typically, you take what is existing, you copy it and you run set on it. And also there is adding, you have to add some boilerplate to VPFTs, Draw, generic filter CXX, and to the component file. But again, it's very easy because you look what is done for the previous ones and you just add your thing into it. You don't even need to understand that. I don't understand it, so there is no big problem with it. For writing a code, there is a class called import filter base that contains most of the necessary boilerplate in every application directory. So So it means that the real work for every integration is just a few lines. There are mainly these filters, they use it apart, write a word perfect filter, which does a lot of additional work, because word perfect actually supports also passwords and several things, so it fires dialogue for password if the password if the document is password protected. So most filters only need to override two functions, do detect format and do import format document, that are just few lines each. You can see that in the old time, this was how we would write an import, a filter detection function. We would take basically the model of the document. We would get input stream from it. We would run something on the input stream, is supported, and then we would get out the name. That was before done according to the developer manual. So we made it a bit easier. So now, for example, the do detect format, you just have one function that you need to know that you need to have in your library a function that can detect whether it is a format supported by your library or not. But then you do something like this and it will be enough. This is an overriding function for that returns in the O string, it returns the name of the type if you detect it, if not, it returns, it puts there nothing, and if returns true if you detected it, and if you didn't detect it correctly, it returns false. That's LibRevenge framework, that's why it's very easy. So, and for filter function is the same. In your library, you will have a document, some function that will take an LibRevenge input type and LibRevenge generator type as parameters, and you just override it this way for your library. The thing is that how to get this parser function and everything, how to do a library for import. Okay, just to say that after you do this, there are still some little configure, some make files have to be changed, but it's always good to ask someone of us, me or David, when he's available. On IRC he's almost always, there is always a particular commit that one can just study and copy. And it's very easy. Once we tell you this, look this hash, we integrated this library in it, you will see what needs to be done. It's not a big deal. Okay. But for example, we were speaking how to integrate with LibreOffice, but how to write a library. We decided that sometimes it's a bit complicated, and there is a lot of similar things that have to be done in the beginning of the library creation, that we were normally doing. Like one day we would spend to just set the framework, or one evening and run set of it, and we realized that actually we can write a tool that will generate the library. And this tool, we have it, you have the Git URL of it, it's called Project Generator, and the script is called Project Generator. And I will actually try to do something, I don't know whether I will manage. It's quite possible that I will be able to create for you the one just dummy library. I just updated it. A moment. Yeah, okay, it's up to date. So project generator, I will call it libloconf. I will put as a command that is LibreOffice confilter library. The author is me. This is my email. for all the girls that want to write to me. The main class will be called Elocon document, and the namespace will be Elocon. So I just run and it will generate something when you see you will see that it created some directory liblocon, and we can now auto-generate the directory. And come on, you're supposed to be quick. Okay. And you can configure it. I configured it with disable variable because it will shut me some errors, because there will be some variables that are unused parameters. So it will configure, it will check whether libRevenge libraries are accessible. I actually created Elocon. LibreOffice con format is a text format, so I will be feeding it to Writer. So, and I can make, and I compile it, and yeah. So it's a skeleton, it doesn't do anything, but it's in less than 5 minutes, you have a skeleton that you can start to program into, which it can be good, because me, it was normally taking me several hours to get the skeleton clean, so. The generator is a software, so if there are bugs, it's always possible to send us patches. So let me see where I am. Oh, wait. So this was the. I will leave it. I will leave the information in the slides. So, if you want to read something more, I published a blog about writing filters that stems from one article I wrote for Linux Magazine last year. So, and David, he started a series of actually specifically using LibRevenge. So if you want to use the best framework in the world, you go there, and I think he actually updated, and there is a part 2 already. And he will be writing after, if someone actually reads it, he will be writing more of it. So thank you so much. If you have questions, you ask. If you don't have, you can go to eat or wait for another person.